Okay, so let us start creating the distributed switch using the vCenter. So first of all, log in your vCenter server. The flash player. Okay.
Yes.
So now we log in our vCenter server. Then go to this icon and select your networking tab. Okay. Then go to configure. So select your data center. And click on a distributed switch. Okay. Right click on the data center, then click on the distributed switch. Now you want to import a distributed switch or you want to create a new one? So you want to create a new one. So create a new distributed switch. To get a wizard, so first of all, like your distributed switch name, like 01.
Yes.
Okay. Location is created on your training data center. Next, the version. So we are selecting the 6.6. This version is compatible VMware ESXi 6.6 and the later. We are using the 6.7, and the following new features is have the machine learning, Mac learning new feature. Okay, good. If you are running the lower version of your ESXi, you can use the lower version of distributed switch. Next, then the number of uplinks. How many uplinks you want to assign to this distributed switch? So we are going to assign like 8. Okay?
Yes.
Or you can assign the more than 8. So we are just leaving the 4.
Yes.
Number of the uplink is 4. And the network input output controller enable create a default port group with the distribute default port group. You can change this name. Okay. Next. Done. So there is the name, versions, number of the uplinks, and name of. And suggested next section, new add the distributed port group. You can make another port group on your distributed switch or add and manage your host. Okay, finish. Done?
Yes.
So now you have a distributed switch. Select your distributed switch and go to configure. So there is other type of properties, like who you want to manage the topologies, okay? System traffic, network resource, other kind of resource. Now I'm going to add ESXi host to use this distributed switch, okay? So go to your host tab. There is no host. Okay, so we are going to add the host. Okay. So click on the action and add and manage the host. So there is a task like add the host, manage the host networking, remove the host, or add host and manage the host networking. So add host. Next. Select your host. So I'm first of all I'm going to add ESXi 1. Okay. Next. Manage the physical adapter, manage the VM kernel adapters, and migrate the virtual machine networking. So you can allow the like of task like that. Okay. And there is the port groups like the VM kernel port groups and VM port groups.
Yes.
And the uplink is VM NIC. Next. Select your physical NIC card that you want to assign with your distributed switch. So VM NIC is assigned to switch 0.
Yes.
I am going to assign the NIC 1. Okay. Assign uplink. Okay. You can select any one or you can assign the auto. I'm going to select first one. Okay. Done? You can assign more than one NIC card to your distributed switch on a host for the redundancy. For redundancy.
Yes.
Okay.
To load balancing also.
Yeah. Then go to next. Manage the VM kernel adapters. If you want to manage your VM kernel adapters, you can manage. Otherwise, you can leave it blank.
Yes.
Yeah. Then next.
Web client.
Okay.
Yes.
Then there's the analysis impact. So there's no impact. Next.
Yes.
Migrating the VMs. So you can migrate your virtual machines. Okay. So you can select and assign to a port group to any one of the machines. So we migrate later. Okay.
Yeah.
Next. And finish. So now you can find in the host entry you have a host. So it's refreshing now. The distributed switch in your host one. If we log in our host one, you can find, in the networking you can find the number of the switch. So on ASXI1, you can find inside the networking you have a distributor like virtual switch. In the switch you have a distributed switch, but in ASXI2. There is a single virtual switch. Okay, because on the distributed switch have the single host ESXi1. We have not added the ESXi2 on this distributed switch. So let's start the another ESXi server. Add and manage the host. Add host. Next. Select your host like ESXi2. Okay. Next. The purpose, okay. Next, assign the uplink. So same, I'm going to assign the NIC one to your. Okay. Next, there are no VM kernel adapters. Next, there's no impact. Next. There are no virtual machine on this server, so it's not showing any virtual machines. And here is the complete detail. Done. Now you can find your another host server here. Like you have two host server on your distributed switch. Okay. You can find the distributed switch on your host too. Let's refresh this one. Okay. Distributed suites.
We have already covered it.
Yeah. Approx. Most of. So now you can find your distributed switch one on your ESXi host two.
Yes.
Okay. So now if you have some virtual machines on the host ones, some of virtual machine on host two, so you can add all of those virtual machine with the distributed switch. And the distributed switch is work like a single switch on the multiple hosts. Okay. So basically if you do some change in the configuration, it automatically replicate your another partner host servers. Okay. distributed switch.
And then all will be connected for the to one network.
Yeah.
Right? Or one port group.
Yeah, right.
One port group.
One port group.
And then from there I can create virtual NAS, I can do this,
yeah.
I can do
that. You can anything. You can do anything, like you can create the multiple port groups.
Yes.
You can create the virtual LANs. Okay.